I want to know what the people of this country are going to do if Rod Rosenstein is fired. We can't take this sitting down. Trump is winning. He's winning, kids. This crazy, wacky guy is winning. And a year into this, he is already, not chipped, has cut away at the things that protect us. Half of this country thinks the media totally lies. At this point, 44% of this country doesn't trust the FBI. Guess what? A year from now, if this doesn't change, maybe this table's in trouble. We keep talking like this. I'm not being dramatic. No. This is what's happening, kids.
Things got serious and heated and emotional on Nicole Wallace's broadcast here this afternoon as frequent contributor Donnie Deutsch ran through the damage assessment to all of us as he sees it so far. Others spoke up today as well, including John McCain, who's home in Arizona receiving treatment for cancer. He wrote today, quote, "The latest attacks on the FBI and the Department of Justice serve no American interests. No parties, no presidents, only Putin's. The American people deserve to know all of the facts surrounding Russia's ongoing efforts to subvert our democracy, which is why Special Counsel Mueller's investigation must proceed unimpeded. Our nation's elected officials, including the president, must stop looking at this investigation through the warped lens of politics and manufacturing partisan sideshows. If we continue to undermine our own rule of law, we are doing Putin's job for him." With us tonight, longtime Republican strategist Mike Murphy, who worked with John McCain in addition to a number of other GOP candidates, including but not limited to Mr. Romney and Jeb Bush. Mike, thank you for coming on. What does it say to you that the most sad and telling comments from the Republican side came to a guy who came from a guy who's not been in the game of late because he's, you know, in the battle of his life?
Right. Well, look, John McCain, my old friend, is what he's always been, which is the bravest and most honest guy in the Republican Party. And I applaud what he's saying. I hear similar things from other senators and congressmen on the Republican side, but I hear them privately. And I think more people ought to speak up about this. Politics is not about declaring war on our institutions for your own personal gain, but apparently this president has no problem doing that.
You surprised by Paul Ryan? Are you surprised this is the most we're getting from Paul Ryan? I keep hearing moderates express disappointment, and people say things like, my goodness, the guy's third in line to the presidency. He's got a custodial function over the nation at some point.
Well, I'm a conservative, and I've always been a Paul Ryan fan. He's my kind of conservative, but I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed in a lot of our leadership. I'm disappointed in a lot of our friends. There's a point where the political game has to stop, and it's not career before country. And I understand. Look, I'm in practical politics. These guys are afraid of their primaries. There's kind of a herd instinct in both parties, which have become tribes. But there's a point where it gets ridiculous. And, you know, declaring war on our intelligence community, who are selfless civil servants who are out there defending us every day, unsung heroes, is a corruption. And we have to find people in the Republican Party willing to say that.
How great is your fear of a reckoning, of a backlash, and how great do you fear that'll be carried out next November?
I'm very afraid. I think if you look at the president's numbers, worst of any first-term president, if you look at the turnout dynamics in the special election, there's a rising protest army against the Republican Party. And the way, you know, we've got 10 months, we will see. Maybe there are some policy agenda things like the tax cut that'll sink in and help. But right now, storm clouds on the horizon, and we're bringing a lot of it on ourselves.
Mike Murphy, do you promise to come back and talk to us?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I'll be happy to, and I will make one prediction. This memo will be over in 24 hours, and we're beyond a shutdown politics.
All right.
I think everybody knows it was kind of a dud, even the people in the Republican Party who thought they were going to start some big trial balloon here. Nothing changed. It's almost an embarrassment.